Now we're going to create a sample application that takes our list of friends and allows us to give gifts to them. We start by making small modifications to the XML file, creating a form that has a list of friends and a list of gifts and a button to give the gift to the friend. Next, we modify our onloadFriends function and so that instead of listing the friends on the page, it creates a menu out of them so that we can pick one friend. Next, we create another function, makeOptionsMenu, which takes a list of gifts that we specify and creates it into a menu so that we can select a gift to give to our friend. Then we modify our initialization function so that instead of just loading our friends, it also loads the gift menu when the gadget loads. The last and most important step is writing the giveGift function. This function takes the gift and the friend that we wish to send the gift to and saves them into the persistent data storage of the OpenSocial API. We do that by creating a new data request object and passing into it a new update person app data request, specifying to save the data under the viewer object. Then we send the request to the OpenSocial API, which stores the data. Here you can see our gadget in action, specifying a list of gifts, a list of friends, and a button to give a gift to the friend. For more information on what I just showed you, check out the tutorial on code.google.com under the OpenSocial section.